right. Are you lonely during this pandemic? Well, this is the show that is going to make you unlonely and feeling back in the love magic saddle again. I know I speak for Doug when I say I'm more excited than a June bug in a cold, sugary bath. Mm. Hey, Dougie, how you feeling about tonight's show?
Good.
Well put, Dougie. Way to add in there. I know last week we had a match, but we had a little problem we'll talk about at halftime of this show. But right now, we have got a show of all shows. We've got a little different view tonight, don't we, Dougie? The view tonight is not actually of people coming in single. They are actually a couple that seem to be having problems during the quarantine. So they want to soil their wild oats by looking out on Quaran-Tinder tonight. So if you would, Dougie, please welcome that very special two guests to our show, Quaran-Tinder, where love matters.
All right, Wink, we have two special guests this week. They're coming to you together. Please give a warm Quaran-Tinder welcome to Terry O'Quinn and Kate Baldwin.
Hi. Hi, I'm Wink.
How are you, Terry and Kate? That's right, is it correct?
That's right, yeah, you got it right.
Well, I'm glad to hear from y'all and just a little bit about the two of y'all. If I'm correct, Kate, I was reading that you are a musical director and head of the whole improvisation, musical improv at the illustrious Push Comedy Theater. How's that experience been for you?
Oh, I mean, it has been enchanting. The theater is amazing. The people there are brilliant. I just feel really blessed to be able to be involved.
I don't blame you. And I hear that your boss is quite the looker. Is that right?
Yeah, he's got a really great personality.
Yes, he does. Now, switching over to you, Terry, the Emmy Award-winning actor. This has to be one of the brightest spots of your whole career is being on Quaran-Tinder tonight. How are you feeling about all of this, being an actor during this time of quarantine?
Oh, well, it's been quiet, you know, like everybody else, we've been closed down. So this is something that I never expected. And it's something that I've been preparing for my whole life. Mm. I'm very happy to be here.
That sounds lovely. Now, I'm going to have to break it down. I heard that the two lovebirds, first of all, how long have y'all been dating?
10 years,
yeah.
10,000 years.
Wow, there seems to be problems at home. Why don't we start with the ladies first? What's happened during this quarantine to make the fire go out?
He never leaves.
I see. That's what a pandemic's about, Miss Kate. It's unfortunately we have to isolate together. Is that the only problem you have? Is he won't leave?
Yeah. Yeah, there's not a lot of space, and I don't know how to do relationships without space, and so 10 years has been great, but all of a sudden this has really changed things. He breathes really loud.
Is that right? That's terrible. Maybe he has some undetected emphysema. Why don't we switch on over to you, Terry? 10 years, what's happened? Where did the fire go out?
Well, was that loud?
Yeah.
It probably somewhere around the third cat.
Oh.
Probably, you know, one cat over the line, sweet Jesus. That's what happened.
You heard it first. The cat went too far. Is that right?
Look here. Everything I got. Everything in my house. Look at my coffee cup. It says meow.
It's cute. It's cute.
Nothing doesn't have cats on it.
I don't know. I hear that, you know, understand correctly too, Miss Kate, you do work with the SPCA. Is that correct?
I do work.
Oh, so your whole life is really about felines.
Pretty much.
Cat, feline, and dateline.
Oh!
I mean, I'll tell you what, it's about crime. I gotta watch the crime shows.
It's really interesting.
Well, it seems like y'all are lonely and obviously going crazy together. I don't know, Terry, I don't mean to be on your side, but I agree, cats can drive you crazy. Why don't we go ahead and do this?
I know people who have like 8 or 9 cats. How they survive.
Well, if I may say, my producer, Dougie, how many cats do you have, Dougie, with all those ex-wives?
I have 9.
Oh, Well, maybe it's time for you to leave your chick too. But right now, I want to go ahead and separate the two of y'all so we can get love back into your life. And I'm sorry y'all are breaking up here live. And what a special place to do it on Quaran-Tinder. Terry, why don't you go ahead and get lost?
Okay. That was a good one, Wink.
Thank you. I wrote that one this week for you. Now, Miss Kate, 10 years and we have had problems.
I know.
Are you ready to get back into the dating scene? It's a different game out there during the pandemic.
I'm a little scared. I've never used a dating service before, ever. So this is brand new territory for me. I'm a little bit scared. I'm a little bit excited. I'm really glad that you're here to walk me through it, Wink, because I don't know how to do it without you.
Well, Wink Massengale, and I speak on behalf of Dougie, we got your back in this pandemic and your front. Now, are you ready to get onto the video and see what it's going to be like getting away from such a smoke monster?
Yes.
Okay, Dougie, it's time to jump right in those videos, and I'm hotter than a June bug, and I already used that one. So go ahead and hit it, Dougie.
Hi there. My name is Gil, and I'm an eligible bachelor. I'm emotionally available and interested in forming a relationship with you. I'm into metalworking, word search puzzles, and sanding. My favorite number is 7, and my spices are alphabetized. I don't own a cat, but I would like to. I used to know how to juggle, but I forgot. In my free time, I like watching street magic videos on the internet. I once went an entire year without sneezing. Not once. If these are things that interest you, please get in contact with me. I'd love to set up a time to chat. Perhaps we could go on a long walk, ride bikes, or forge a sword. This is Gil, signing off.
Wow.
Wow!
I really liked the wave.
You enjoyed the wave. Gil seemed to be a puzzle maker and really wanted to uncrack that puzzle. What did you think about that?
I loved it. He wants to forge a sword. I've never done that before.
And I couldn't help but notice a pattern. He said he didn't own a cat, but he liked
it. Yeah, I know. It kind of feels like it's meant to be right off the start. I got to say, though, at what point do you start counting how many days it's been since you sneezed?
You know, it's glad that you brought that up, Miss Kate. He said 1 year, and you bring up a point. How did he start counting?
When did that happen? I wonder what prompted that, but that makes me think he's a real thinker, and he really pays attention, and I like that in a man. I do. And he does sound like he likes to walk. It didn't sound like he was reading or anything. It sounded really, like, from the heart.
It did. It seemed very, very natural. There were a few things that maybe it's a good thing that he doesn't like to sneeze during the pandemic. I thought that might be positive as well.
That's very true. I don't want to get sick, and I would rather have somebody that keeps his germs to himself.
Yes, and he's right away. I can already feel a better love connection than you and that man Terry by a mile in that one.
I know. I mean, Terry's never forged a sword. He can
have
knives and do all kinds of cool things, but I don't think he's forged a sword.
No, and more importantly on that, he seemed down to earth and genuine. So I'm going to have to ask you this, Miss Kate. This is a big moment. Are we not having any part of that sneezing problem and swiping left? Are we thinking about swiping right, or do you want to see that next video?
No, I really like him, but I can't just pick the first one. I mean, if he's the first one, there's got to be really good ones after this. So can we just, like, put a hold or a maybe on him? And
that's a very good idea, because if we didn't, there really wouldn't be a show.
Oh,
hey, okay. Dougie, hit that next video, because I know Kate is very charged up.
Yes.
Hit it, Dougie.
Franklin, is the yacht ready? Of course, yes, fetch my phone. Everything is, yes. Must be behind this pile here. There we go. Ah, very good. Well, hello, ladies. I am Bartholomew Latouche. You may have heard of me. My family is among the most prestigious in the paper products business. And as you may have heard, I have decided to depart on my yacht. We are social distancing ourselves from, lesser abled and less well endowed. And I'm now looking for a few select ladies to join us for the voyage and make the passing the time a little more enjoyable. And perhaps one lucky lady may even get to become a Latouche and get on my insurance.
Holy Christmas tree!
Did he just pull
condoms out? I'm sorry?
Did he just pull condoms out of his pocket?
I couldn't tell what that was. I know his name was Bartholomew Latouche. What did that make you think of?
It made me think of butts. And he's holding toilet paper, so I'm just gonna go ahead and say it. I do like that he has a yacht. That's a perk. But he did say that he wanted a few ladies.
Does that bother you?
I'm just branching out. I'm not sure how wild I am, and I'm not quite sure what the toilet paper has to do with it.
Mm. I was under the impression that maybe he had made his money off the toilet paper, but I wasn't quite sure. He also seemed, at times, a little sweaty. I don't know, it seemed like he was nervous, but then again, douchey. Thoughts?
Douchey Latouche. I think that I had a hard time noticing the sweat because I kept looking at the things in his pocket and I couldn't tell if it was like, I thought it was like a candy bar. And then I realized halfway through it and I kind of stopped listening because I thought he has condoms and there's four of them.
You counted just as many cats as you have as he had condoms. So I don't know if I'm feeling a swipe right here, but I would love to ask you the question. Was there any kind of match on Quaran-Tinder with that lovely douche?
I'm intrigued. I'm intrigued by him. And anybody that's named Bartholomew is an interesting person for sure.
Mm.
But I think I want to move on and see the next video.
Bam! She said it right there, and if it matters, I don't blame you on this one. Hey, Dougie, what do you say you hit that next video so we don't have to watch that guy talk about his tush anymore?
Salutations! My name is Scrambles. I'm 8 years old with a slight hip condition, and I live in a beautiful house in Larchmont. I enjoy sleeping, looking out of the window, and birds, especially dead birds. I hate toes. Before the virus, my human would let me go outside and flirt with all the neighborhood cats while she was at work. But now that all the humans are home, I stay locked in the house all day. I'm looking for a perfect playmate to let me sit in her lap and make biscuits. I'll bring a whole new meaning to the word pussyfooting around. If you don't swipe right, I'll swipe left on your favorite boss and watch it crash to the ground.
Meow.
Wow. That was a meowsing.
It sure was. And right up your alley, a cat man. Was he a real cat?
I can't tell. You know, he started off by saying he was 8 years old with a bad hip. And that's like, cats have bad hips, and 8 years old is considered a senior. I know, because I'm in the industry.
We've gotten that point down almost to the point of ad nauseum.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I do think that he might have been a real cat, or at least he believed it in his heart. And if you believe it, then that should be so. I do think that he's really interesting, and I'd like that he would like to sit in my lap. I mean, that's the best part about cats is that they're great companions, and he seems like he'd be a great companion.
Now, a couple things I couldn't help that just sort of jumped off the screen for me, Kate.
Yeah.
Is one thing that was really bothering me there is that, did he say something about that he was going to give you a biscuit? And the other part that was awkward was, he said he loved dead birds, and I know you're an animal person. Is that something that bothers you, that he's a dead bird lover?
Well, if he's a cat, it would make sense because that's just nature. And I'm not going to frown upon nature, but I think that I think biscuits, I like biscuits. Cats are great biscuit makers. And so if he was not a cat, or if he was a cat and didn't know how to make biscuits, then I think that would just be weird. So I think it's a plus for him, actually. His voice was a little bit high. That's one of the challenges. I don't know how much I could take of that.
I can imagine you went from a Terry O'Quinn who's very known for his voice to someone that was so screechy that it almost messed up the whole Zoom conference we're having right now. It's so off the charts. So what are you thinking? Kate, are we left, right, or do you want to see that next video?
It hurts my heart because I've never said no to a cat before, but I think I want to move on.
Okay, you heard it right here. She's got 9 lives, and we're going to meow on to the next video, Dougie. Hit it.
Hello, my name is Frank. I am a conspiracy theorist and alien abductee. Did you hear that? Anyways, I am looking for love of the non-extraterrestrial kind, if you know what I mean. I hate getting woken up in the middle of the night and waking up on a operating table where parts are getting probed. I'd rather know who the woman was who was going to do the probing beforehand. But the voices in my head say otherwise. That's why I'm wearing this aluminum foil shield against the reptilians of SETI Alpha Sigma. Anyways, pick me for an out-of-this-world experience. I have an extra aluminum foil hat shield for you, too. Gotta go, they're calling.
Wow! Nanu, nanu! Kate, I don't know if that did it for you, but it sure as heck fire did it for me. Tell me your thoughts on this outer world man.
I loved him. I mean, he's not paranoid. Like, there's stuff out there. I watch a lot of Dateline, so I get it. There's noises, and they're not explainable, and there should be an explanation. You know, the aluminum foil hat, I think that that shows that he's intelligent and that he's resourceful because he's using things from around his house to protect him. Why the look?
It just seems like you were actually into that man.
I think he's great. I think he's great. And I think that, he probably has been abducted. And do you not believe in that stuff?
Wait. It's not that. He just said that he was going to do the probing and there was so much weird double, like sexual innuendo in that. I didn't know where to start or begin. He wants to know who does the probing. I'm going to be honest with you. I thought you were an upstanding citizen until you started liking this man.
I didn't pick up on the innuendos. I was just paying attention. I was just thinking about, I'm confused.
He said that they probed him on the operating table and he'd like to know who probed them and he wants it to be you.
Oh. I just thought they were doing like alien stuff. Like, I don't know. I missed that part. I was just more enraptured by his story. And that he's experienced that and my heart went out to him. I'm sensitive to people's experiences, Wink. And it sounds like he's had a really tough one, and I felt for him.
Wow. To be honest with you, in a million years, I never thought we may have had a Quaran-Tinder match with that really strange man. But I will tell you, I can tell you're on the fence. Swipe left, swipe right, or are we going to go on to that next video?
We're going to the next video. I'm not committed.
Hit it up, Dougie!
Hello, my name is Provolone, and I came on to Quaran-Tinder because I want you to nibble on me like a little piece of cheese. I promise you, if you take a bite of me, it'll be Gouda. Swipe right.
Oh My dear heaven, that was the sexiest man I have ever seen in my darn life. And I know you feel the same way. Kate, tell me about how that man made you rock the pandemic.
He was kind of like a chipmunk. I'm not really sure what the gestures with the mouth were. It was like he was talking about eating cheese, but he was like a little woodchuck doing little chipmunky things. It was weird.
I think it was trying to be very sexual and very attractive looking. From a woman that loves animals, I want you to rethink this because he was good looking as hell.
He had a cheese hat on that was a little distracting. I have a feeling it was covering a bald spot. I'm not sure. I do like bald men. I'm not going to lie. I mean, in the past 10 years, there's not been a lot of hair. But I think that gentleman was hiding something. Like, you don't wear a hat that size unless you have something to hide. And I think that gentleman had something to hide. I'm not sure I trust him.
I think your instincts are all screwed up. You know how they say a cat has instincts, cat-like reflexes. Your cat-like reflexes are completely wrong on this one. I know for a fact what he was doing was acting like a mouse. Sexy as hell.
A mouse. Yeah, I mean, I guess that would make sense with the acting like a mouse and being all about cheese. I'm just curious as to what his past was like, if he's had like one girlfriend or like a ton of girlfriends, because obviously whatever he's done is not working. So I think it might be worth like thinking that through a little bit more. Maybe there's some soul searching. Maybe he should look at Swiss cheese and the holes and how empty that is, and it might reflect the emptiness of his soul. Or the holiness of his soul.
Well, Doug, we're going to move on here. Kate, it seems like you've got some big decisions, and then what you just said, I'm going to completely throw out the damned window. But I will promise you that right now is your chance to be thinking. While we're going to go get a moment from our sponsors about which one you want to match with. You've got a lot of picks. You had the alien. You had the man that wanted a crossword puzzle and didn't sneeze for a year. You had that hot cheese. Did you hear him say he was Gouda? And Kate, we're going to try to get you away from that stepfather of a boyfriend, okay?
Okay.
We'll be back with you. Think about it. Right now, a word from our sponsors and about last week's winners from Quaran-Tinder. Kate, see you in a minute, you jerk.
Hey, gang, this is Dougie saying we have more Quaran-Tinder on the way. But first, let's hear what our sponsors have to say. Hey, everybody, it's me, Dougie. Are you ready to see last week's winners? First up, we had Emily, a preschool teacher from Chesapeake. You voted, and Emily is going to be quarantined with Draven. Congratulations to the happy couple. Then we had Denny, a furloughed employee from Bob's Gun Shop. You all voted, and Denny got matched with the pirate. Unfortunately, we have sad news here in the world of Quaran-Tinder. Not long after we recorded our episode, our friend Denny passed away. Let's have a moment of silence for our good pal, Denny. Now let's get back to more Quaran-Tinder, but first, we gotta check in with our sponsors.
Welcome back to Quaran-Tinder. Yeah! Still no sponsors, Dougie.
Nope.
Good work. That's why we're giving you all that money during this pandemic, but I can tell you, I have got something very special. Our winners last week were lovely. We had a little bit of problem, if I'm correct, with one of them being deceased now due to the Clorox drinking, but I'll promise you this. He went out with a bang. Now, I think it's time, if you will, Dougie, would you introduce that next guest for us again?
You may have seen him in The Stepfather Part 2 and The Forgotten One. Please give a warm Quaran-Tinder welcome to Terry O'Quinn.
Hi, Wink. How are you?
Terry, how are we today? Welcome back to Quaran-Tinder. And just in case you didn't know, he's in such things as Perpetual Grace, which is great out there. We have, of course, Lost that's out there, My Young Guns, and Tombstone. You're a real heckfire friend. And thank you for being my friend, Terry. But more importantly, Wink wants to get to the bottom of your love life.
Fire away, Wink. I'm all yours, so to speak.
I don't blame you. We just hung out with that girl of yours, Kate, for a while, and I think it was time for you to get moving there. Now, Dateline. How much Dateline are we talking about? She watches.
How much Dateline is there? All of it. I mean, I think she's watched all of it, and she's probably watching it again.
And the thing I've never understood with Dateline, Terry, is that they have an announcer, a narrator, that announces another narrator. It never quite makes sense to me. But who am I? I'm just on Quaran-Tinder with no sponsors.
Well, I said Dateline. Oh, I'll tell you what else. I don't know. Maybe it's a guy thing. Homeland. I started, and I just, there's so much girl drama. I just couldn't handle it. Dateline. Homeland and cats. I mean, what more need I say?
I think it's time to kick bricks. And Terry, it's time right now. Are you ready to find a match to get away from that woman and find a new love for you? Somebody that will really understand the Terry O'Quinn that we all want to know and love.
I am ready, Wayne. I'm ready.
Oh, Dougie, we've got him right here. The Emmy-winning actor is ready to get his Quaran-Tinder on. Hit that video for Terry.
Well, hey there, the name's Maureen. I'm a bit of an end of the world Armageddon enthusiast. As a matter of fact, as we speak, I am down here in my underground bunker that I have created underground. I have got every weapon that you can think of, from a solar powered ray gun to a shank. Now those can kill anything ranging from zombies just to backwoods intruders. Got enough astronaut food and water supply down here to last me for at least a year. So good news is, whoever swipes right on me, not only can we polish our weapons together, but we can also cuddle underneath the earth together. So after this all blows over, I'm really hoping to be able to repopulate the earth with whoever swipes right on me. So do yourself a favor and save the earth.
Boom! Repopulation, Terry. You heard it first there. Tell me what you're thinking about that little overprotective woman.
Well, I think that Maureen seems like someone who's really well prepared. She obviously has plans. She's looking out for the worst that can happen, and that's a good thing. She's well armed, which I appreciate. I don't get, you know, as you know, I got a few skills, you know, heaving the shank, as Maureen would put it. So we have that in common, and she's got a place to hide out in the event that we need to hide out. So, you know, that's all pretty good. Repopulating the earth. Yeah.
Now, Terry, I couldn't help but notice that. Did you just admit on live air that you have a shanking ability? Is that correct?
I learned in one of my many jobs how to throw a big knife fairly accurately. if you're attacking me and you stop the proper distance away, I can take you out.
Man, that is a skill, Terry. Now, what are we thinking here? Left, swiping right. Oh, there's a cat coming in the background. You lucky man. Or do you want to see that next video?
Oh, you know what? Maureen was cool, but I would love to see the next video.
Oh, she was lovely. Well, let's shank right on in there. Dougie, hit that video for Terry.
Hello, I'm Robert Smith from The Cure. You might know me. You might know a couple of my songs. Friday, I'm in love, just like heaven, love song. The point is, I'm an amorous guy. I love love. And with this quarantine and the social distancing, I've just been very lonely. So I wrote this song here to kind of pour out some of those feelings and hopefully get some matches. So here we go. I don't care if Monday's blue. Wait, it's Monday, that can't be true. I don't know the days to you. It's and I'm in love. All the days could fall apart, but you know I won't break your heart. Wait, I'm married, that's a start. But threesomes are quite nice. I want to get laid. Two chicks would be really great. But dudes, please don't hesitate. Just swipe right and you will see what coitus is like with me. Plus my wife, that makes three. It's when I'm erect. Thank you.
Holy Cure! That was one lovely woman, her man right there. Terry, what were your thoughts of Robert Smith, I guess, of The Cure?
Yeah, I believe that was a Robert, yeah?
Well, yeah, so.
Robert is very musical, and he seems very generous in that he's obviously prepared to share his wife with whoever might decide to jump into that. But
I couldn't help but notice that, too.
As you might know, I play a little guitar myself, so, you know, hanging out with somebody from The Cure, very attractive, looks a little sleepy, but hey, I get that way sometimes too. Probably been at home too long.
Now, did it bother you that he didn't know the days of the week, Terry? Is that something that would upset you or get underneath your skin?
No, that doesn't bother me at all. I don't know the days of the week, so, I mean, but, you know, on the other hand, maybe it would be good to have somebody who actually does know what day it is.
Somebody to compliment you.
Maybe his wife knows what day it is. So,
yeah. And that British accent was quite on cue, I thought.
Well, yeah, I thought it was lovely. I thought I wasn't going to be able to understand Robert for the whole time at first, but I caught up, you know, as you do in films and things like that. Robert seems nice, kind of musical, like the ukulele.
It seems like you may be on the fence about this, about swiping left, swiping right, or do you want to go on to that next video, Terry?
No, I think I'm gonna hold my thinking on that, and I'd love to see the next video. That'll be
cool. Let's do it right now. Dougie, without any further ado, please hit that next video for the lovely Terry O'Quinn.
Oh, lololo, it is Sylvie from Paris. I am here stuck in Newport News, my flight home on the airplane is not able to go back to France, where everything is better. I have been trapped in this country for so long that I am starting to take on American custom of making the French toast. In the France, there is no French toast, this French toast looks like a pile of dog shit, if you ask me. I try it. We try it together and see how it goes. I probably would die. The powdered sugar is just really, it's a, it puts it, oh. So, I finished the French toast that the Americans love so much. And I must say my belly is full, but my heart is still empty.
Ha! Je mange beau coup et toi? Terry, what are your thoughts on that little French lion?
I thought she was, I didn't get her, I lost her name, I didn't get her name, did you?
I just thought her as Frenchie. Yes, I didn't quite understand her name. I didn't understand a lot of things she said.
Sophie or something, I think. Yeah. She seemed at a loss for words sometimes. Apparently, there's some that escape her. Airplanes seem quite difficult. although she seems like a lovely girl, and apparently she can make French toast, so she may be a French chef, which would be kind of wonderful. I mean, I cook a little, but I spent some time in Paris, so I could exchange a few words with her, but no, and she didn't say anything about repopulating the earth, so I don't know. I'm still up in the air about that.
I don't blame you on that one. Now, let me ask you a few questions that are very poignant on this one, if you don't mind, Terry. One is, she seemed absent-minded with the blah, 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 blah. Did you notice that?
Yeah, I think that's a French thing. I think it's sort of, je ne sais quoi, which is funny that that's a French phrase, and the phrase really means, I don't know what. So
yes.
But let me say, I thought she was attractive. She seems like a lovely woman. She's starting to adapt to American ways. So that's a possibility.
Did you find it awkward that she said, I am in America and I'm going to make French toast? Did that seem odd? It'd be like my going over there and saying, I'm going to make American buffalo. It just seemed awkward to me.
Yeah. Well, I think it seemed awkward to her too.
Wee-wee, Terry. Wee-wee. Now, are we thinking a swipe right? A swipe left? Or are we going to je ne sais quoi?
Je ne sais quoi.
Dougie, je ne sais quoi, the next video for Terry, please, right now.
Merci.
Hi, everyone. It's me, Carrie. Very excited to be here on Quaran-Tinder and hoping to find a very special someone. Don't be afraid of how I look. I'm just a fun-loving girl from panties in a twist. The recent tragedy didn't affect me at all. For I am legion. I am many. Let's have fun in the afterlife together. So go ahead and swipe right.
Don't be afraid. Lay with us.
Don't be afraid.
We just want to play.
We won't bite.
Just swipe right.
Swipe right.
Ho! Get thee to a nunnery. The women from panties in a twist scaring the hell out of us. Terry, what did you think about that woman of multiple personalities?
Well, are they all part of the deal?
I think they are, Terry O'Quinn.
Well, the afterlife is accounted for there. I mean, that's nice to know that, you know, in the event, well, not in the event, but when I get there, maybe sooner than she will, I'm guessing, that they will all be there and I will have lots of company.
You sure will. Was there any part of you that was a little creeped out when they all started talking that sort of almost monotone, scary talk?
It kind of hypnotized me. I think they're going to be able to do that. They're going to kind of hypnotize me and, you know, do whatever they want with me.
Sounds like to me you are a little intrigued by this.
Could go either way.
Hey, Dougie, you really picked one right there that I think tickled Terry's flavor. But I know right now you want to see that next video, don't you, Terry?
Oh, you know that I do.
No, I think I know we have a match, but wait until you see this one, Terry. I can speak on behalf of this one. This is one of the best actors of our time. Please, Dougie, hit him up with that next video.
Buenas noches, señoritas. Me llamo Zorro. I have come here on Quaran-Tinder to find a woman who will become my caballero. I will fight for justice and freedom while I bonsoir on your back. Please swipe right, and then I will swipe back, and then we shall swipe together. See. Caballero. Me llamo Zorro.
Oh,
well.
Dios mio, Terry O'Quinn. I'm not sure he was on here to look for you, but I promise you this, when you have an Emmy award-winning actor on, sometimes you got to show off your acting ability. I'd love to just have your thoughts on how masculine, how attention to detail, and how good of a character and how he stayed in that accent felt for you, Mr. O'Quinn.
That was a supreme bit of acting. I wonder if Kate see that person?
Kate did not see that person. If she had, she would have definitely had her leg quiver. You know.
Probably. Now, yeah. I think she might be gone for sure now if she had seen Zorro.
I don't blame her. Now, you have worked with such people as Kurt Russell, Val Kilmer, Sir Ben Kingsley, all of these lovely actors and actresses that you work with. Have you ever seen anyone with such attention to detail as that man right there?
No. I've seen no one that Zorro like Zorro. Or, you know, bone swat on anyone's back like apparently Zorro.
I'm going to take this moment forever. This moment will always be on my Facebook page that Terry O'Quinn said that about my acting. Now, Terry, we're at the end here.
Wait a minute. That was you?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Did you?
I was doubling up. If you need me as any kind of acting partner, I'll do it for free. You've seen my place. Now, well, Terry, it's that moment of truth right now. Where are we feeling? I think it's time for us to bring both Kate and you in here since y'all are done as a couple, thank God. Dougie, why don't we go on to that sponsor right now and bring in Kate back into the game right now. Dougie, hit him with a sponsor.
She's watching Dateline. I'll go get her.
Welcome back to Quaran-Tinder. Still no sponsors, but maybe something will change about that tonight. And if not, Dougie, I think I'm going to have to fire you.
Oh. That's okay. Fair.
Understood. Now let's get back to them. Bringing back Kate and Terry. They're back on the show right now, and y'all are about to break up. I think this is great. Tell us, Kate, have you narrowed it down to two people? Two people that you want to court? Good. God almighty, the two people that you want to narrow it down to get rid of that Terry O'Quinn.
That's really, really tough. There was a lot of variety there. And, you know, this is potentially my future, so I want to be picking right. I think I got to go with Gil.
I'm
intrigued with the sword.
Oh! Terry, I hate to say it, he really did give you a run for money and virility, did he not, Kate?
He did. And it's between the cheese guy or the alien guy. The cheese guy or the alien guy. And I think it's got to be the alien guy. I mean, I just love that he wonders so much, you know? And he didn't do the thing, which was kind of nice.
Terry, I don't blame you for leaving this woman at all. As a matter of fact, if you're single, I'm ready to go out to the block when we're out of this pandemic in down in Virginia Beach. Kate, good luck on your travels over there. I really mean, I hope you have a job as a musical improv teacher again in the future. Because right now, it's in damn peril. Now, Terry, here we are. Buddy, you and I, he just told me how great Zorro's acting was. But right now, we're not worried about the acting. We're worried about you finding a love connection. What are you thinking, Terry?
I'm too bad you didn't see Zorro. That's what I'm thinking. Yeah, he was hot, even to me. But he's not going to be my first choice. Because, you know, I just don't fly with the Z. But I think that there are a couple that kind of interest me. And all the girls in the afterlife sounds kind of
you know,
multiple girls.
Well,
there were multiple girls, Kate, from Panties in a Twist and All Girls Show, doing all these things. Which unfortunately, you yourself were in Panties and Twist, but somebody's gonna be two time or six timing or whatever that was, Terry.
I don't know if that was one person with eight personalities or eight women. So you know, I'm gonna say that's one, and then the other one is probably Sophie. You know, the French girl who makes French toast. She was a little. I think she was having a bad day. She was a little grumpy, but she did like the French toast, and she seemed like she, you know, she's kind of exotic.
He likes French bread and French cheese, so it does make sense.
Don't act like you know everything about me.
Oh, well, it seems like we have a love match, Jamaj Boku, and it seems that they are breaking up. I am sorry to hear about y'all breaking up, but it seems like we're going to find a Quaran-Tinder match. Kate, Terry, we have loved having you on this show, and I promise you I speak for my man Dougie on this. We're going to get y'all unlonely during this quarantine.
Okay. Sooner the better.
That's it. On behalf of Dougie, I am Wink Massengale telling all of y'all again, please make love, not viruses.
This has been Dougie. We'll see you next week for more Quaran-Tinder. And remember, if you can't be with the one you love, love the one you're Quaran-Tindered with. We'll see you next week with an all-new Quaran-Tinder.